Maloe tau mai pung pungini nisam pulupinaka na turanga ke na marama kia ora tātou. John Pulu here with this Tangata Pasifika COVID-19 message. And joining us is the Associate Health and Education Minister, Jenny Salesa. Maloe lau maari and a very good morning to you, Jenny.
Maloe lele and warm Pacific greetings to all of you.
Yeah. Jenny, the country heard yesterday that Auckland will remain at alert level 3, and the rest of the country will remain at alert level 2 until 11:59 on Wednesday, the 26th of August. And I understand that the cabinet will meet. I think before that on the 21st, before a further announcement, if we extend this lockdown or we will end it. So, what's the latest so far, Jenny?
So in terms of the cases, what you would have heard yesterday is we have 49 active COVID-19 cases here in New Zealand right now. 19 of those cases are from the border, but the number that's most important, especially for us Pacific people, is 30 of the cases. These are the community transmission cases out of that overall 49. Of that total of 30, two-thirds, 20 of those cases are Pacific. And so my word of encouragement to all of us Pacific people, please go and get tested, especially if you have flu-like symptoms, if you have, you know, symptoms of a cold, a cough, a fever, runny nose, if you've lost your sense of smell, please go and get tested, either at your GP, your local doctor, or you can go to any of the 15 community testing stations right around Auckland. It is very important that we get to the bottom of COVID-19. As you all know, we were able to successfully fend off COVID-19 once before. We absolutely can do it again, but for all of our Pacific communities, very, very important that we get tested.
Yeah. Jenny, can you tell us about some of the testing stations that are situated around here in Auckland in particular, especially now that we know that 20 active COVID-19 cases are Pasifika? Can you tell us more about the process of how people can get tested?
So my advice, actually, the fastest, if you don't want to be waiting for a long time in a queue, is to ring Healthline or go directly to your local GP. Ring your GP first, and then go and visit them. The wait at your GP is actually not as long if you go to a testing station. The testing stations are around South Auckland especially, as there's one at Ōtara Town Centre where the flea market is. There's one at Airport Oaks. There's also one that's been opened at the Māngere Town Centre, and there's one at Wiri, the Whānau Water Centre over in Wiri. But for the actual locations of all of the testing stations, if you're wanting to go to the testing stations, go to covid19.govt.19, covid19.govt.19. Not only does it have the locations of the testing stations, but also it has information in all of our Pacific languages. I know that it's very important for our people to get information in Tongan, Samoan, Cook Island, Niuean, and the like.
Yeah. Jenny, what about your advice on masks? Because I know that in the first lockdown, people were going crazy over hand sanitizers, and now it's masks. What would you like to tell our community about wearing masks?
So the advice from the Minister of Health, as well as the Director General of Health, especially for those of us here in Auckland, when you leave your residence, if you're going for essential work, like essential work, or if you're going shopping or going to the pharmacy, please put on either a face mask or a scarf, a bandana if you don't have a mask. You don't necessarily have to have a store-bought mask. You can even, there's some video links where you can actually cut your pair of socks. I would advise you actually make sure it's a clean pair of socks, but you can actually make a mask out of a pair of socks as well. Important to cover your face, both your nose and your mouth. It is more about if you do have it and you're coughing, that you're protecting the rest of the community that is close to you. Also very important that we keep to the rules that we're used to for alert level three, which is social distancing, keep to the 2 meters level, 2 meters apart, sorry, wash your hands regularly, absolutely wear a social a mask, especially if you're on public transportation, the bus, the train, or if you're close to someone else, please wear a mask, especially those of us in Auckland.
How important is the COVID-19 app for track and trace? Because it's a bit close to home now with the new cases in our community, for our Pasifika community here in Auckland.
Very, very important, especially for the contact tracing. There are hundreds of people that are now being contact traced by the public health officials here in Auckland. And my advice is, please, if you haven't downloaded it to your phone, COVID-19 app, download it, because then the public health officials will have a record of your name, your phone number and your address, if indeed you are one of those folks that's, needs to be contact traced. Also, very important that when public health officials get a hold of you, if you have been in close contact with any of the folks who are COVID-19 positive, please answer the questions in full and comprehensively, and please answer them as appropriate. We know that there are information that's really, really important. You might not think it's important. Say, for instance, places you've been, people you've talked to, how long you've been with them. It is very important because it is the best way for all of us to get on top of and eliminate COVID-19.
Jenny, may I also invite our viewers as well not to forget the 2 meter distance when you're out and about or outside of your house, and also a 1 meter distance when you are at the workplace, and also washing your hands all the time. Jenny, there's been an extension to the wage subsidy. Is there anything you can tell us about that for our community?
So there will be more detailed information that our Minister of Finance, the Honourable Grant Robertson, and our Minister of Social Development, who does a lot of work here, our very own, the Honourable Carmel Cipollone. I expect the details of the extension to wage subsidy to be announced in full around about Monday next week.
Yeah. What about this year's elections? I know that a lot of people were gearing up. I know you've been busy campaigning as well as other candidates for this year's general election on the 19th of September. Has the government made an announcement around delaying it, or what's the latest?
The Prime Minister is the person that actually decides the date of the election. She has given herself 48 hours as of yesterday. She will make an announcement, I believe, on Monday. But for now, our party, the Labour Party, has, suspended our election campaign. So none of us are actually doing anything in terms of politics. Our main focus right now, John Paul, is getting on top of and eliminating COVID-19. And the focus of the government is saving people's lives. You know that that was our focus before, and one of the reasons why we got on top of COVID-19 is really because it's thanks to all of the members of the public, our team of 5 million. What we're asking right now, of course, is the team of 1.5 million here in Auckland. Can we please unite and ensure that we eliminate COVID-19, that we break the chain of transmission of this virus? We know we can do it because we've done it before.
Malo Pito, Associate Health and Education Minister Jenny Latu Salesa. Malo.
Malo Pito.